Hi guys, welcome to my The Art Vlog or the YouTube channel with me, Kira here. So today, I'm gonna be making a tutorial for the first time. So what am I gonna do is a background tutorial. Okay, because this tutorial was being requested by Rostrock a couple of weeks ago. So yeah, I managed to finish it this week. So I hope it can help you, Rose. So I think we can get started. Okay, for example, last week I managed to finish this background. As you can see, it should be sakura flower theme. So I don't know whether it seemed like sakura flowers, but to me, yeah. So I'm gonna show you how to do it, this type of background. Okay, first, go to the file, a new file here. So as you can see, this is my size and this is my image size. So click OK and you can see, voila, it's coming right up. And we go to the layer. As you can see, the background here, just ignore it because yeah, it doesn't bother you at all. So as you can see, click new layer in here, then the new layer will be pop up as the first layer. So after that, to make things easier for you, you pick the character that you draw, but make sure the layer is transparent as this behind. So whenever I draw, I'll just make sure that the layer behind is transparent, so whenever I transfer it, it didn't bother me to clean up here. So yeah, as you can see, I'm gonna pop up here, choose the move tool here, and I'm gonna drag the character to this layer. Okay, when I'm done, I'll put back the character to my tab and click this tab back, and as you can see, the second layer has been pop up because I add on the layer from this to this, so the move tool will automatically put the new layer here, so it's okay. Then I'm gonna rename it as the main character or MC. Click enter. Okay, one thing you need to make sure is let the main character up, not down the layer like this layer. Make sure it's the upper layer from the first layer, because we don't want the layer that we're gonna color it or we're gonna draw it overwrite this layer. So don't disturb this layer, let it be. So choose the first layer back and then I'm gonna choose my brush because I'm gonna start making a branch. Yay, my favorite things of all, because the branch tree is easy to me. Okay, then I'm gonna choose the color. As you can see, a dark brown color. There you go, this one, and click OK. After that, I'm gonna choose the brush size, say probably 250 60, no problem. Okay, and then click OK there. So make sure the layer mode is in normal, and my type of brush, I'm usually choose a multiply mode here, so my opacity 100, and I'm using a pen pressure because in Photoshop you can choose whether you want or you don't want, or you same with this, the flow, you want the flow or you don't want the flow, because I'm using a tablet, so usually it has the flow on its own already. So yeah, I think we can start it now. Now I'm gonna make the it bigger a bit, so I'm gonna start draw. Okay, now let's start draw. Hooray! Yeah, first, as you can see, there you go. Honestly, you just draw whatever you like. It's not this the one I just show to you how I draw the tree. No. I mean, how do I make a background? So yeah. Oops, sorry. Okay. There you go. This is my tree. Yeah, I love draw a tree because it's, I don't know, right? To me, I think the tree is kind of nice. It has a vibe on it, probably because the nature. I love the nature. Yeah, honestly, I really love the nature. Well, you can say, it just doesn't need to be straight or else there. So yeah, just draw that wherever you like it. So as you can see, my kind of style of drawing for the branch is already different. So I'm sorry, Rose. I still love color the tree. I don't know, the tree made me feel so calm. So yeah, I do love color the tree the most. And it's not because the tree is easy. I like tree, I think. There you go. I'm just make it simple, Rose. There you go. So you can make it a color even darker for here, because this one I'm showing you an example. If I try to color it more detail, I think it probably took me 2 hours. Trust me, I've done that before. So I'm gonna take the second here. Wanna draw a tree? Don't you worry, just let the hand guide you. You just think how the tree, how the branch go, the flow of the branch, because you could see the trees outside, how they grow. Well, if we learn the science, you should know. Sorry, it's not about the science, it's about the art right now, but yeah. But, yeah, you can see there. This is my type of the tree. There you go. Now make it nice. There you go. Or if you think it's not enough, well, I could show this thing. Too many branches, it's not like it's so unnatural. There. There you go, I'm done here. So the next step. Well, if you want like a real tree, I mean a realism tree, you should go outside and watch how the tree grows. You know what I mean? It's not like from the tiny and from the big. You just see how the form, because a lot of tree have a lot of different forms there. Because sometimes it goes straight out like a pine tree there, make a nice triangle, or sometimes like an old tree, a bigger one, or as you see a sakura type of tree, there's a lot of branch there. So yeah, there's no problem there. So this is my type of tree. So yeah, so I like, honestly, I really love making the trees. I don't know why. My previous drawing does involve the tree a lot. Probably, but I'm telling you, if you make this a dark type of background, yeah, this thing or this tree gonna be a spooky tree. Yeah, you see, you just draw it until you feel like, wow, it's turned nice already. And you can see my, yeah, I do feel like it turned nice. And if you want to make it a little bit darker here, just color it until it becomes darker. So yeah, it's ready. Finished. Done already. Okay. And make sure the layer down below from the MC, like I told you before. Okay. There you go. I'm gonna make a little bit darker here. So yeah, it's done. Okay, so to make it more nice, add one more layer here, the second layer. So choose the brush, no, I'm sorry, choose the color. I'm gonna choose a little bit light chocolate here. There you go, this kind of chocolate or brown. And I'm gonna choose this layer, a multiple, and then I'm gonna color it. There you go, see? It's not, I'm sorry, it's not a multiple, it's a multiply. Well, this is happen when you get too nervous. Good job, Kira, good job. So, even in a paint to style, the multiply blend mode is also available, so don't you worry when you try to use it. Okay, nice and steady here. As you can see, the color of the tree change. This will be, want to make it like a real tree there. So let's try our best here. There you go. There you go. I'm just gonna show simple, but still, it's the tree. And if you guys realized it, I actually didn't do a line art on my BT from the start. It's not that I didn't want to, but actually I kind of lost how I'm gonna start to do with the line art here. Probably because I'm the beginner for the background. Usually I'm focusing on my main character. Did I think about the beachy? Okay, I think it's already nice. I already done with the touch up there on top of the branch here. Yeah, I think it look nice already. So for the next step is I'm gonna make a sakura flower for the tree. So yeah, I'm gonna add on the layer there. After that, I'm gonna pick pink color, but a faint color. I like a faint color. Click OK, and then we can start it. And make sure for my brush spacing is none, or unclick it because I don't like it. It's gonna disturb me. So the brush size depends on you guys, which size that you want, which more you're comfortable with it. After that, you can click OK or enter, and you can start it in. And make sure that your layer mode is normal and my layer brush is multiply. So I think we can get started now. There you go. So let's begin. Nice. Wait, I think I made a mistake there. Yeah, I need to undo it back. My hardness is 100%. Usually I make it 0%. If in Psy you could choose a airbrush here, mine's, yeah, wait, yeah, I see it there, airbrush for the Photoshop. But in Psy they actually have for the airbrush, this one they include everything, so you need to go there and pick airbrush, so no problem. Okay, then let's continue. Yeah, color. have a technique to color it, as you can see. But if you think the brush is a little bit smaller, you could make it bigger by changing the size there. There you go, 800 probably too big, or 500, nice. So it's up to you guys. So yeah, how you have a technique how to color it. I don't know how to tell it to you, but you could see how I do, and I'm gonna speed up the video for this part, because if I follow the flow, probably take a long time for this, trust me. So yeah, as you can see, it already formed a texture from the faint to thick color. If you think the MC is quite disturbing, you can switch off the layer first so it won't disturb you. Okay, you can see now this texture looks like sakura flower or a baby form. Although I don't know, from my eyes I think it's looking good already. So yeah, just do the technique. Yeah, let's see. Yeah, do like that. It's up to you guys how you want to do, but as long as you could see the form of it, this texture actually. And this is my style I usually do. Yeah, for the background I'm kind of not too expert about this, but I try my best. Hopefully it can help you guys. Yeah, so yeah, I'm already done. It's look nice already. So for the small tree also, you just color it until you see the form of the tree and this texture. So this is what I usually do. That's why I use some multiply, because from the faint color you can override without damaging the color texture. So it looked pretty nice to me, so that's why I'm using a normal for layer and a brush mode for multiply. And my opacity is 100, but I'm using a pen pressure, so I click on it, it won't disturb me. There you go, I think it's nice. And I'm gonna add on one more layer and choose pink gray for my shadow. Yeah, and after that, as you can see, I'm gonna choose a multiply for my layer mode. Yeah, gonna be nice. So let's begin there. Edit as the shadow. So put shadow here so it's not from the tree down below. Same here. And same here. I put here a bit. So if you think it's too much, don't push it too hard. So okay, as you can see here, it's almost done. But usually I'm gonna use a smudge tool here, as you can see. But in the paint tool side, you can use a blur tool. My blur tool, I don't like it. I use a smudge. So I'm gonna smudge it a bit. It's just like when you use the hand to smudge it in the traditional art. So same like digital, you smudge it on a digital paper, just like that. So yeah, as you can see, yeah, it's become just like this. I like it so much too. My favorite. Oh, blue is so nice. No, don't you worry. Blue is also nice. Just I didn't use it frequently. There you go. My tree is done. And to add some more layer here, put a little bit white, not white. She's really faint pink, I guess. Here and go. Just to make it more look lively. I'm sorry if my English kind of broken here, because I've really been quite nervous. Nervous before. I'm gonna use a smudge tool again. Things is enough. And if you wanna do some line art here, there is no problem. Let me show you a line art in here. So, okay, this one. Choose a light brown or more light vein, I think. And then make sure the brush is small. Okay, 52 or 53 is nice. So let's make the picture bigger. I'm gonna use a rotation here to rotate. So I'm gonna use a brush bag. I'm using a hotkey. So yeah. Oh, sorry. I just realized that I need to make it have a spacing bag. There you go. So how I end up making this? There we go. Just a simple nice one. I'm just making a simple, really a simple line art, just to show that, oh yeah, this is a sakura tree, that it does have a bit line art. Although I'm pretty, I don't know, making a line art for my background, pretty big failure actually. Yep. I didn't do a line art here while I'm recording. As you can see here, it's disturbing. But it's okay. I'm just gonna show. There you go. As you can see now, my sakura tree is done. And for my next step is, I strum the layer here. Voila, it's done. The next step is to make let's see what we're gonna make. Okay, first, we're gonna make a cross. So make sure the layer is, oops, on top of the second layer. Why is that? I'm gonna make sure that the grass is override this tree root here. So choose the brush back. I'm gonna choose this type of color. This time, nice and steady. So choose the brush size. A little bigger. Okay, it's nice, 400 is really nice. So let's start color it. Oh, I just remember I chose a tall one. So yeah, as you can see, the color is not and so nice. So I'm gonna undo back all of it. Erase it because I can't undo all of them. Okay, choose the brush mode back to normal and let's start color it. So yeah, I like this. Okay, make sure, there you go. Well, to me, it's still nice. I like it, probably because the tree or something. There you go here. Okay, and then choose a small brush. I mean, a small size of brush here. Okay, why? We're gonna make it look like a tree. So yeah, just like this. Just nice and steady, nice and steady, nice and steady here. Okay, same here, nice and steady. Let's just make a small one, don't you worry. Okay, after that, you could use a blur tool there, a blur brush, but I'm gonna choose a smudge. I'm gonna smudge this only a tiny bit, but it's okay, it's not disturb anything, honestly. Okay, there's nice. After that, add more layer here, the upper seventh layer, the eighth layer. Choose a darker color for the grass. Choose the brush. Small is nice this size. So let's start color it. As you can see here. And make sure draw like this. So we just want to make sure that you make like a real grass and to add like realistic a bit, make this thing multiply mode brush. And I'm not sure whether paint tool size available for this brush mode, but Photoshop, yes, they do available here. So yeah, okay, as you can see, I'm done here already a bit. I'm gonna put some more down here. So if you want to add more realistic, no, more realistic actually, if you think you can do this, okay, choose a little bit darker green, make it smaller size, I guess, and yeah, let's make a flower here. That's what I mean actually. Sorry. Yeah. If you want to edit, it's no problem. Like I say, I didn't use the line art here. So my flower is just a simple flower, as you can see. So yeah, because this is normal, this is multiple, a normal layer, you can add on a flower. Should be. So yeah, I'm gonna add some flower. Although I don't know if it turned out to be nice or not, but sorry if it doesn't turn out to be nice. A little big. I'm gonna use this mush. Kill it. The green tap here. To be nice. And then I'm gonna choose an orange, a brush, and go to the third layer. So if anything happens, you could just delete it. I mean, erase it. Yeah, this kind of flower, I just want to draw it, although I don't know. Yeah, I rarely make a line art, and I'm sorry, and I choose a yellow. Probably this color almost look like a fade out color. There you go, it's done. See? Just one flower. Sorry, Rose. I just got to overreact. Okay, next. Actually, it's the final step already. So, the upper layer. Oh, it's not the final step. Okay, behind the first layer, okay, the 9th layer here, put it behind the first layer. But why? We're gonna making a cloud. Not a cloud, I'm sorry, a sky. Probably this color of the sky. So I'm gonna choose a paint bucket tool. 1, 2, 3. Ta-da! Okay, nice. After that, a 10 layer, just a white one. Why? We are gonna make a cloud. A nice one. Okay, so spacing here. Well, no spacing. There you go. Now let's get started. That's odd. Oh. Okay. There's something disturbing me actually. That's why. Yeah, I know already. Should I choose the bigger or the better? Because yeah, I need to pressure these things a lot because they're not coming out Let's see, if I make this spacing, does this thing come out? Oh, it does. So yeah. There's no need to make a lot of cloud there, because you're gonna make the sky fit out. So I just put a bit here and put a bit here, and there is done. So the next step is the 11th layer. Make sure on top of MC. Why? Because we're gonna draw a flower petal. I do have the instant one, but I rarely use it. I usually draw by myself. Okay. So here, let's start draw the flower. As you can see, my line art really thin. I should make it bigger a bit. Okay, that's nice. Still thin. I don't know why. And too thin, I think. Just paint bucket tool. A pink. Oh, a little bit thick. At this color. And there you go. As you can see, you can make two type, I think. Choose back a light brown, this one, and color and draw it another. Okay. Choose a faint color for sakura petal here. There you go, it's done. And you can see it's too big. After that, I'm gonna choose my lasso tool here. Choose this one first. I'm gonna choose a move tool. Wait. Yeah, a move tool here. I'm gonna go to edit and free transform to make it smaller. You can do whatever pose you want. Okay, I'm gonna make it like this. Later, and then I'll click OK here. As you can see, I'm using a move tool here to multiply or duplicate it. So I'm gonna hold Alt and drag it and drag it and drag it. Okay. Same step also, but this time I'm gonna choose a lasso tool to free transform it and turn around. We gotta make sure that the leaf kind of really falls down. Okay, so click OK and same technique, move tool. there. As you can see, my background is finished. And this is the result. And you can see there. So here, I'm gonna write something. Initializing type tool here. There you go. I'm done. So this is gonna be. Voila! The background is complete. So yeah, I think that's all, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next tutorial again. I hope so. Bye bye.